Why is she getting on him like that?
I can see that bullshit from a mile away. See it. You can step my mother about a mile away. I got three white bitches like it's powder day. White mink coat with them rolls like a Sharpay.
And not all of my bitches says it calls Barbie.
She looking back like I'm flexing, baby, no way. And lately I bet on that juice.
I wanna see this bitch.
I'm all at the
chick. Have you ever?
I done seen it probably.
It's possible.
You probably like, do other shit on the yard.
Damn. It probably look like a little rabbit. Like from this, you know. Like a little animal. Yeah. I see the fat rabbit from a mile away.
If I need some rest, I'ma flip me some cracks. I talk like I want it, she don't say nothing back. If cop pull up, I put that crack in my crack. I put that brack in my brack. Call the show, he made a fuck on my
road.
If you don't owe me, bitch,
y'all fuck with that boss?
I promise I won't ever quit, bitch, I'm
cold. Niggas talking to get a check,
I will that white, you can sh-
okay.
Yeah,
bombs dropping. That just mean we in this bitch.
We on a Michael Bay production film right now. Transformers in the bitch.
I feel like we about to get interviewed. Like we just dropped a fire ass movie at Sundance. Got the edits in, baby, because we got that stimmy.
Yes, sir.
How you feel after you got your stimmy?
You ain't get that.
Yeah, I ain't get my shit yet.
Yeah,
niggas got theirs over the weekend. That's cool. You know, shout out to the casino.
It's really y'all fucked, y'all. Hit.
I'm just hating, though. I'm going to be honest.
I got that bit last night.
For real?
Ooh.
In the middle of a radio bar. I said, I'm bro.
What you going to do with it?
I don't know, son.
Y'all ain't got no plans for y'all 1400?
I don't have 1400 from the government yet, so.
I'm saying, okay.
When you get it.
But that's different.
In the future.
Yeah. I don't know when I'm getting it. So I'm probably going to stag it.
Yeah.
It don't make no sense.
I'm about to pay off some debt, and I'm about to buy a PC, for real.
Are you about to build a PC?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to buy, like, with Gucci socks running about 100 some a pair. I'm, you know,
how many?
However many 1400 equal to.
He gonna buy 14 pairs of socks.
14 pairs of Gucci socks.
Yeah. You deserve it, sir. Shout out to Moneybag Joe for blessing.
Nah, we ain't
nigga.
Calling that nigga that
you
shit.
You not fucking
yet.
With Moneybag Joe.
Why you not fucking with that, son?
Fuck no, I ain't about to call that nigga that shit till I get that four wheeler. That need to come in a package too.
You want the four wheeler so bad.
Yeah, bro. You know, my birthday May 10th, you know, tap in. Everybody put 500 together.
Son, if you go to Facebook Marketplace, you can get one for like $200.
You're going to fall off that bitch and be blowed. Now why you going to put that on me? Because you're going to be doing crazy shit.
You probably shouldn't buy a four-wheeler from the marketplace. Then the nigga get shot off that bitch. Like,
nigga
like
got shot
last
off a four-wheeler?
No, like he was selling a four-wheeler on Marketplace or whatever, and that nigga shot him. I think it was in like New Orleans or something like that.
Oh,
yeah. Nigga get shot for anything, though, son.
Yeah.
Look at what a conversation went. Welcome to North Vice Radio.
Yeah, niggas don't want me to get that phone number.
I'm your host. Well, I'm one of your hosts. Niece. Y'all niggas know me. Yeah. Y'all know everybody in this bitch, man. Y'all know.
Sterile sweat shirt.
Exactly. Y'all know G.
What up?
And y'all know Top Cat. My light skinned brethren.
My light skinned brother. Yeah.
G is too, but you know. You're a little more light skinned.
What up?
Uh oh. Am I wrong?
I don't know.
What episode is it?
Oh, episode 20.
We turned 20 today.
20 weeks. In.
Yeah.
That's a long time, son.
I guess we got a new set. Shout out to us, nigga. We on our shit. How y'all doing, bro? How
advances.
Was y'all week?
Ooh. My week was low-key ass again.
You said it was ass?
Yeah, no progression in this bitch.
Damn,
no.
Oh my God.
That sucks.
So last week we spoke on the raise I was, you know, talking about.
Where?
And I brought it up to my boss. I was like, hey, you know, because I was just flooded at work.
Mm-hmm.
And he could see it too.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, all right, this is low-key the perfect opportunity to tell this nigga, hey, I need a raise.
What day was this?
Thursday, maybe.
Okay.
Wednesday. This is Wednesday. Okay. So I told him, like, hey, you know, remember the interviews, like, every 6 months I'm eligible for a raise? He was like, yep, I sure do. I sure do. We're going to work something out. The very next day, he hired somebody else.
Ooh.
So I was like, I ain't going to hate on a nigga for trying to get a job, trying to do better shit in his life and all that, but I still need my money at the end of the day.
Well, it's still possible you could get your raise.
I don't think so.
You don't think it's space for a raise and a new hire?
Mm-mm. I don't think it's going to happen, so fuck that nigga. I might end up hey, going man, back to EA.
Don't block your blessing, son.
I hope y'all boss never find keep the it.
Keep, you got it. You should keep
a. I hope that bitch do find it, so he could, you know, cause like even when he hired a new nigga, you know what I'm saying. I was just at work and he was just avoid conversation with me, cause he knew it was. I guess in my opinion, he knew it was fucked up. But I was just like, whatever, bro.
We do need another person in that bitch working though.
So. Right.
Yeah. Well, and I ain't mad at that. It's just like, man. This a bitch ass shit, but I ain't, you know, I ain't gonna be a hoe about it. You know what I'm saying? I'm still training niggas, still show love and all that. But you, and specifically, need to stop playing with me. Mm. And that's just all it is. Fuck this week, though. This week wasn't.
Be more stern. Be like, bitch, I need a raise.
This week wasn't raw.
I'm sorry to hit us.
Yeah.
Shake back, son. I don't even know what to tell you.
I had low-key back surgery this week.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was that.
How do you low-key have back surgery?
Yeah, you that.
You know, it wasn't like crazy. You know, I had to get a spinal injection, like in my lower spine. So that happened. I did that Tuesday morning. I had anesthesia and everything. Yeah,
it put
crazy.
You up, huh?
I woke up hurt as a bitch, like worse than I was feeling before.
Really?
Because that shit was like, I was just sore as fuck for like the whole day.
I can imagine. I mean, I that fucking back surgery, so.
Right.
Why you ain't send us some pictures? You know what I'm saying? They had buku pictures in rotation. And I ain't get one of them. And I just want to tickle my dog. Just want to see how you was doing.
I'm going to send it to you now, son.
He had the little, you know, in the hospital?
Yeah, so my mom would, like, she rolled up. She's like, gotcha. I was
like, really?
He had the medical cap on.
Yeah, I was fucked up. I had tubes in my nose.
Medical bonnet.
It was down bad.
Your back still hurt?
No, nah, I'm straight now. Okay. I feel way better.
Can you like turn up still? Like, yeah, I can probably drink like liquor and,
you
can
jig.
You know,
I could
like
jump
dance.
A fence probably.
Okay. Yeah.
Shit, yeah.
Okay.
All right, you straight then.
Dunk. Yeah. All type of
you
shit.
Got that. One surgery. Yeah. Come on now, my dog an athlete.
But shit, yeah, that's
So you had a good week, I'm guessing.
I mean, I guess besides that, it was
I mean, your back feel better. I thought that was positive.
Yeah, I guess you know, so. You're right.
Find the good and everything. What about you, Top Cat?
I had a crazy week, actually. I was in a very reflective mood. Like, you know, I was just thinking about a lot of shit that I've been going through in my life and shit like that. You know, trying to improve on myself, really. Like, where do I go from this point?
Mm-hmm.
And then last night. All right. So, like, I get to the crib at around, like, 8 o'clock. And I'm walking up the staircase. And I hear, like, you know, it's a Friday night. It sounds like a little party by the little pool or whatever. 30 minutes later, rah, 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 rah. And then I hear more gunshots. And then I just hear a whole bunch of people just like drive off in their cars and shit like that or whatever. So it was just like, I guess it was just a Friday night, you know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to keep it cool or whatever.
Yeah, you in the slums. What you it's just a Friday night.
Yeah, it's just a Friday.
It's a regular
night.
Friday.
But I mean, it's been crazy since the since they started leasing to like Southern students and shit.
Oh,
like it's not even like
that's the correlation.
But that's because last year it wasn't like this. It was
still the niggas came.
All right,
so then like I want to say, cops pull up by like 10 minutes later. All right, so I'm like on my balcony just trying to peep out the scene or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
All right, 10 minutes pass, they knocking on my door. So like I opened the so like they knocked twice. I didn't answer because I didn't know who the fuck it was.
Right.
They didn't announce themselves or anything like that. So I go like towards like the bathroom or whatever, because I'm about to get the deagle, you know what I'm saying?
Keep the deagle in the bathroom?
That's
a strange place to
just
keep.
Just in case a nigga try to run up on him when he's taking the shit.
I don't exactly.
That's the worst. Yeah.
Pretty much. Cause I'll be in the
shower. You got your hands out, you can't really right. do
too. I don't wanna get caught without it on the toilet or in the shower, honestly. That's like where I'm really vulnerable. So I'm standing in the hallway or whatever, and then it was just like, oh, maybe we should announce that we did sheriff's office or whatever. All right. So like I go and open the door. Nigga got an AR-15 and like pistols in my face. And just like, the fuck? Who the fuck is in here? So it was just like, you know, I walk outside and then you gotta understand our balcony like light is off or whatever. So I don't know what the fuck is going on. I'm telling him it's just like I don't think anybody else is there. I don't know. Cause I just got home from work and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He was like, well, you should know if there's somebody in here. And I'm like, dog. Like, dog. Come on, bro. It's right. like I'm a little stunned at this point. So like I walk outside and I look down and it's just like there's a trail of blood like leading towards my door. There's blood on the wall, and then there's blood on that chair right there. Son.
Little speckles of blood.
I'm splatter. Just like, I have no clue as to what the fuck happened or anything like that. I didn't hear anybody come close to like the door or anything like that.
Why
so
you shot that nigga,
like,
son?
Oh, man.
Down, this the cover up. This your alibi.
Hey, this my story and I'm sticking to it, man. This my truth, son.
I'm snitching.
This nigga said he hit the group message and say, niggas letting it fly right now. And I was like, what the fuck is letting it fly? I thought niggas was fighting, you know.
I mean,
yeah, you gotta say niggas busting right now, niggas shooting, like you gotta, you know what I'm saying?
I ain't have to. I said what I said and I just put the phone down because it was just like, it's crazy.
My dog was scared. I get it, bro.
It was, because it was like, it was more than just one person shooting. It was like multiple, like somebody cleared a clip, two clips in that bitch. So it was just like, yeah, it was like war zone outside for real. I tried to find some peace in between by playing Warzone. It was just like,
Oh, you was playing the game while the shootout was happening?
Yeah. Yeah.
Didn't help.
It didn't help at all. I was just I got back on there. I was like, hey, man, I got to go.
They shooting outside.
Yeah, it's wild right now.
Well, you know, sorry you had to experience some Baton Rouge shit.
Right.
It is what it is, man.
That's crazy as fuck, though.
Yeah.
Son, what that was, like, Sunday, two people got killed on Jewel Road, and that was crazy as fuck.
They got killed?
I thought the niggas just got shot.
No, them niggas was on the floor, like, fucked up. I gotta go find the video. But it was like, it was crazy because we was just on that street to like go to my grandmother's house. So like 30 minutes before that, like them niggas got shot the fuck up.
In a place, in a time, you know?
Exactly. Yeah. That shit fucked me up. I was like, damn, I was just over the...
Yeah, be safe, man. It's summertime, so stay y'all ass inside.
Yeah, or just try to summertime, yeah, but yeah.
Hopefully that stimmy, you know, calm y'all nerves down.
It go boost niggas up.
When does money ever stop niggas from shooting each other?
They about to get some more guns.
Shoot you in these Gucci socks.
Dude. I ain't gonna stand. I low-key wanted to get another gun, too. So
do it. Fuck.
What you want?
We won't get into specifics, but, you know, I want to splurge with my shit, but at the same time, I don't know what I want to do with it. Because I know, like, last year, I was like, damn, I should have just stacked that bitch. So, I'm probably just going to be responsible for real this time.
Word.
Responsible curve.
You know, I'm getting old.
They should have set the stimulus before All-Star Weekend so all these hoes wouldn't be stuck in Atlanta.
Wow. Yeah, they was really stuck for real. Son, I seen so many GoFundMe pages and shit.
You got a GoFundMe because you can't afford a flight. But you in Atlanta shaking your ass.
She said she
hopping out of U-Haul vans and shit.
Didn't she say that she was like waiting on a paycheck or some shit like that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Waiting on her unemployment.
Yeah. Like she was just waiting on the check.
No woman should be stuck anywhere.
What do you mean? Like,
are you saying they should be able to finesse the situation?
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. I believe in that.
Because they got
definitely.
Power.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Maybe she just wasn't.
But you ain't got the power to go home.
You ain't got the power to make no money.
If you understand what I'm saying. I don't want to say what I was saying.
Yeah, I feel what you're saying. Like, you should have a good trick to make sure you got away home.
Gerald is saying sell your pussy. Like, let's just be honest. Just sell your cat. You ain't got no way home.
I mean, it's OnlyFans era. So
that's
All-Star
Weekend.
It's just like.
But figure it out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Maybe. did y'all see the
don't
chick?
Sell your pussy.
Did y'all see the chick? Was she like ugly?
No, I've seen multiple women.
Yeah, but there was a lot of people.
Oh, there was multiple?
Yeah, okay. They was in U-Haul vans and all types of shit.
So yeah, I seen a few of them hopped out of minivans and shit.
Like, damn, is it that serious?
At what cost?
Hopped out fresh as a bitch, though.
But I told y'all last week, I was like, it's nasty in Atlanta. I've been hearing some horrible stories.
Gerald can vouch.
Yeah.
But I hope they're all safe, ultimately. Like, it's funny, but.
If you're still out there, you just dicked out. Yeah, you ain't never going home. Yeah. You might as well start your life
catch
as a junkie.
Bus. Do something. But, you know.
The mega bus.
You shouldn't go anywhere knowing you don't have enough money to, like, get home, feel like.
Right.
Don't make no sense to me at all.
As a woman, I feel like that's dangerous. As a man, it's lame, but it's more dangerous as a woman, for
facts.
Sure.
Yeah. Big facts. Yeah.
So. You know what I'm saying? Be safe.
Get on safe.
As a man, you homeless. You a junkie.
You know what to do.
You could be homeless and not a junkie, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can just be homeless. Yeah, you can just be fucked up with it.
Just hot pills and be junkies.
Snapchat. Fucking.
I hope they get hoes safe if they ain't hoes yet, for sure.
Niggas can't get mad at you for laughing at that, though. Like, that's funny to me.
It's hilarious.
Like, goddamn.
You had no plan.
You just had to go to the club. You had to get that pitch off. You had to see Lil Baby, bitch.
And Shmurda and
just couldn't help your fucking self.
Them hoes wanted to see Zion.
You think that's what it was?
They wanted to see Zion.
They
wanted
to see John Morant.
I don't think the hoes wanted to see Zion.
Yeah. Look, the hoes want to see Zion do a dunk, man.
That nigga was missing all them fucking dunks in the All-Star game.
Who he had replaced? It was,
I don't know.
I forgot. But it was like last minute. And they just put him in that bitch. Y'all saw the celebrity game?
Yeah, the whole.
I think I watched the highlights from it or whatever.
Yeah. Man, that shit was funny as fuck.
Quavo came out there, was balling for
Quavo
real.
Quavo scored like 17. They was going to 21.
And he like scored over 2 Chainz as well. And 2 Chainz was like really a baller.
6'5"?
Yeah.
2 Chainz like 50. I don't know how old 2 Chainz
he
was.
Like 46 or something like that. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. When was the last time 2 Chainz played like basketball on a team? Didn't he play in college? Mm-hmm. How long ago was that? Yeah. 1930s?
Alabama State or something?
You know what I'm saying? We got to stop acting like niggas can hoop because they hooped 30 years ago.
Right. Yeah, they could have got some other people, son. Lil Baby just couldn't hoop at all.
I mean, but he put out like the he put out that album with what is that, LeBron, so it was like maybe he was like, you know, they were shooting in the gym. Hey, you know,
hoop was only tape.
Yeah.
He executive like produced it.
Yeah, sure. That's what it was.
So 2 Chainz had Lil Baby on his team. And Quavo had Jack Harlow.
Yeah.
Maybe 2 Chainz just needed a better teammate. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I think that's all it was.
But it's because of the league. They have a league game series that's on like Revolt TV on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
Shit like that. Yeah, Jack Harlow was he was a part of that.
Jack Harlow was like, fucking, I ain't about to even shoot this bitch. Just here, Quavo.
Yeah, he just passed it off. He played his position. Like you're supposed to.
That's what's up.
I guess.
If you in a 2-on-2 game and your nigga hot, you gonna pass
him
the ball.
I feel like they could have put me and KD out there against anybody. The one I told y'all this last week.
You and KD. Yeah. You not even gonna.
Me and KD. Me and KD versus anybody, we gonna win.
Shit, no. Why LeBron and AD?
Come on, son.
LeBron and AD
versus Moose and KD.
That's a mismatch. That don't count.
Is it on them or is it on y'all?
It's on them.
Yeah, what the fuck? We gonna bust their ass? I'm not even going to entertain this today.
Legend ball.
Who gonna check me, AD?
Yes.
Why did you ask that question? Like of course.
When did LeBron check that bag?
He's it like, don't matter who it
might
is.
Be something with this nigga.
They gonna lock Moose the fuck up.
I'm just gonna pass that bitch.
How?
Give it to KD.
How? You gonna be stuck in the corner. You're not even gonna be able to inbound the ball, son.
My bad. You go do your shit. I'll take everything I
said. Yeah, y'all do that bad. Y'all don't want the black man to win.
All right, bro.
Me and KD versus Lil Baby. No, we not doing this week. What other topics do we have?
Lil Baby low key like disappointed the fuck out me.
I mean, yeah, I ain't had no faith in that nigga. I seen that bitch like, do 2 squats, and then he was like, "Let's get it." After
he like, "I'm ready, nigga."
He couldn't stretch. He
know that nigga ain't stretch at all.
Man,
son.
That nigga couldn't. He was trying. He was trying to copy Jack Harlow. He just couldn't stretch.
Yeah.
Hey, I ain't gonna stop. I can't laugh at him though because I don't know how to stretch properly.
But do y'all stretch before y'all ball?
I should. I mean,
should you?
Like whenever we.
It's been a minute, but
I'm gonna be honest. I don't.
I'm just asking.
Yeah, like 7 years ago though. You know. Yeah.
Okay.
But Cardi B became the first. Is it the first woman?
Yeah,
to have
she
a
was
diamond?
The first woman to have a. Was it diamond? Yeah, she went diamond for Bodak Yellow. It was the single.
Oh, yeah. Bodak Yellow.
Yeah, Bodak Yellow.
Yeah, she's the first woman to have a diamond single.
Women's History Month, Black Women's History Month.
That's crazy.
Yeah, rapper.
Shout out to Cardi B. I ain't gonna say I'm so happy Cardi B hit that before Lauryn Hill. I'm sick of motherfuckers acting like Lauryn Hill just the greatest female rapper all fucking time.
Yeah, but she went her that album went diamond. Miss Education went diamond.
Oh, dang, Bodak Yellow.
The album went diamond like a couple weeks ago.
I thought so. But so Bodak Yellow like the first single to go.
It's the first single to go.
Okay.
What does diamond mean? I'm about to look.
It's 10 million copies.
It's 10 million.
Is it?
Yeah, I think it's so. Because platinum is like a milli, I believe.
So diamond is 10. Yeah.
That's what's up. Shout
That's
out
crazy.
To
yeah, gold is like 500K, some shit. Yeah.
Did it really go? Did it really go diamond though? Because the streaming is different. Like, do I really want to count that? I'm gonna count it's Women's History Month. My bad.
He trying to dismiss it.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
what that mean for Kodak though? Like,
Cardi B win, I win. Cardi B won, I won.
Yeah.
That. I think
he probably get like royalties.
He get a check. Right? He must definitely get a check. Yeah.
I don't think that nigga would.
That
nigga
no, ain't he, got no he credits. He definitely gets a check.
I mean, the song was based a little bit off of one of his songs, but I don't think he's sampled or.
Yeah, I don't think that nigga gonna get nothing from that shit.
He in the name of the song.
Bodak Yellow? Not really.
Bodak. It's Kodak.
I mean, we know Kodak was inspiration, but I don't think he gets paid from this shit.
I feel like he does. Yeah.
Really?
I wouldn't think that he would be like, if she went, I win, like without him getting a check. Just knowing who he is. 1,000%.
He probably thought of it like a clout weight, like, oh, you know, you use my name, that's what's up.
Kodak been turned up this week.
Yeah, that nigga.
In general. Or like last week, whatever week that was.
I think it was this week.
When is Kodak not turned up? He been turned ever since he got out of jail, low key.
I feel like that shit against Pooh Shiesty was like a little unwarranted.
But what happened?
Well, Pooh Shiesty did like a money fan or some shit on IG. Yeah. And then, you know, Kodak was like, these niggas my sons, these niggas won't be like me. Y'all know where that shit came from, man.
He got a point though.
I mean,
but Shiesty showed him like pictures where he was like 10, and he was like, he also got inspiration from Chief Keef and shit like that. Mm-hmm.
Y'all are not the first niggas to pose with money.
Yeah,
right.
Even if you are like, what?
He was like in the stance, and he had like money on both arms, and he did like the brr. So it was a little crazy.
He had to do that shit to that man. He just wanted to fuck with Pooh Shiesty, sir.
Yeah, Kodak just fucked up. But I'm on Kodak's side.
He's always a person that's won his respect because, like, with the little Yachty thing, when, like, smoking broccoli and shit like that.
Oh, yeah, that shit did happen.
Yeah.
I guess niggas just.
I feel like that's just setting trends.
I mean, what do you expect?
Yeah.
I don't feel like it was worth Pooh Shiesty getting so angry over, but what the fuck do I know, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he was blowed as fuck. I guess because he looked up to Kodak, and he's like, damn, bro, what the fuck?
Yeah, I think that's really more of what it was.
I took it as Kodak just joking, like, really just fucking with him. Like, I don't think he was really serious. Because even in another video he posted, he was like, it ain't that. Like,
He was like, I'm not trying to...
keep it cute.
Yeah, he got in his feelings about it.
Yeah.
Chill out, Shiesty,
man. Nigga just, you know, Kodak, you know what I'm saying, a little throw nigga.
Y'all know how C-cap
nigga, you know?
Somebody tweeted, I knew Pooh Shiesty was lame. When he let another nigga tell him he was more shiesty than him.
I mean,
nigga so stupid.
But Pooh, you know I'm really shiesty.
Yeah.
What's up? What other topics do we have, man?
The Papa John's, like, going into N-word, what is therapy?
Nigga therapy.
What was the quote that he said, son? It was so wild.
I don't know. I just saw an interview with this nigga, Papa John, whatever his name is. His name is John, right?
Yeah,
he was on the news, and you know he got in trouble for saying the N-word before. Mm. He was like, you know, I think he said him and his team have been trying to do something for like a few days where he's like basically been in nigga rehab.
I thought it was weeks actually.
Yeah, it was.
I thought it was like the bigger past. I thought it was like the past 33 weeks or some shit like that.
It says ex Papa John CEO says it took him 2 years to get rid of this N-word. It is vocabulary.
Mm-hmm. God, damn, how much you was saying that?
Damn, son, like.
What you gonna say, nigga?
The crazy part was when he was like tried to make it seem like the company had a conspiracy against, like, conspiring against him to like get him out of there. He's like, I don't understand why Papa John's would do this. And
he walked into the headquarters one day and he was just like, nobody was saying the N-word. He was just like, he said it. He was like, nigga. And it was like, why are everybody looking at me like this?
Is that what happened?
No.
I could believe that shit.
Like,
but that's what it had to be like.
I think he just fucked up, son. I don't know what's wrong with that dude.
He throwed.
Yeah, he just throwed
all the memes was funny as fuck. It was like Buku songs with like nigga in it. Mm-hmm. And he was like, damn, I can't say it.
Niggas in Paris.
Better piece of better
niggas.
I have
a theory that every white person says the N-word.
Yeah.
Facts.
I think it's like a
white, I know y'all say it, son. Like, I know they say it. Like,
yeah.
It ain't stopping every motherfucker from saying nigga. Like, it's impossible. I know they say that shit when they listen to music.
Right.
Yep.
It's like, whatever, bro.
You let Spanish people slide for saying nigga?
I really just, I don't even care no more, bro.
You don't care no more?
Like, like, don't say it around me.
Yeah.
Like, that's cool. It's disrespectful. And most people respect that. But I can't control what these motherfuckers say.
You can't, bro.
I just hate they reasoning, like, oh, I'm Poe too, so I can say nigga. Like, I grew up around blacks, bro. Like, man, no.
Right, bro, I don't give a fuck where you grew up at,
I'm
bro.
Not white.
Don't.
They
also use it improperly. Example, what's up, my nigga? Might be a Mexican dude, Hispanic person, anybody that's not black, non-black, whatever. First of all, I might not be your nigga.
Mm.
What's up, nigga?
It's like, Why are you even speaking to me?
Pass the ball, nigga.
Pass the ball, nigga.
So I don't know, son.
It's, nigga, what you doing? I think
niggas let 6ix9ine say this shit. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
What about Fat Joe? Like Fat Joe said Big Pun.
Hey, you know, I mean,
that's what that
you,
New York shit.
Just, at the same time, you know what I'm saying? Them niggas be like, I'm going to stab you if you say anything crazy to me. So it's like, you want to get stabbed?
I mean, you know, they always got a knife on.
What, New York niggas in general just have knives?
Or like Hispanic niggas.
That's a crazy vibe.
Like a knife on dick.
I think Cardi B was saying she had like a blade in her mouth or some shit like that when she linked up with
this shit is real.
Yeah,
like blade on the tongue.
Yeah.
What the fuck you doing?
We passed this up, but I see there's a topic that says All Star Weekend is the draft combine for cuffing season.
I believe that
the draft combine for cuffing season.
Yeah, it's the draft combine for cuffing season.
You seen the little video? Where, like, the chick randomly had to go to Atlanta suddenly.
Yeah,
to visit her auntie.
Yeah, he's like, where the fuck you going?
She's going out there to show that ass. That's where she's going. I think it's the draft combine for cover season because it's like, all right, let me see how you act out there.
See, I disagree.
I think
it's just slut time.
I mean, it's demon time. I get it. Yeah, you know, like, go out there, show your ass. You
I'm not saying
put your good clothes on.
All Star
Weekend. Good clothes on.
But, you know, I just see it for what it is, you know. But you know what I'm saying? If you're going out there to shake your ass and then want to come back to, you know, your home state, then I'm about to settle down.
Right. Yeah. make it back safely.
Yeah. Did y'all see that couple that went to Salt Bay's restaurant?
Yes, I did.
What
how y'all feel about that? So Salt Bay, like, you know, he was doing his little thing. He was like seasoning, salt, and then like
salt on the meat and shit.
And then, so like he picked up a piece. And he put it in her mouth, and then she just like had that bitch like this.
She had a tongue out.
Oh yeah, I saw she like tilted her head like 90 degrees.
Yeah,
she had a tongue out.
Goblin that
and he laid the meat down on her tongue in front of her nigga.
And a nigga in the background, he was just looking at, just like.
But it was so blown.
But you gotta low key.
What would y'all do in that situation? Like, what would y'all do in that situation?
I'm a record her and laugh at her. I'll be like, look at you, you deep throating this fucking.
Slam.
Yeah, like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
You saw the other like video of her dancing?
She had a video that same woman was dancing?
Yeah, she got
I ain't see that.
That old ass.
Yeah, so I wouldn't even trip.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I get it. I get it.
So if she was a little uglier, you'd be blowed. No. That's what I'm getting from this right now.
But if you see that ass and you see how that ass moving, that's like, okay, it's I'll
passable.
Take it. Yeah, I'll
that's
take
what I'm saying.
It.
Like, if she, that's what I'm saying. But if she wasn't fine, you'd be like, this is not acceptable.
Mm-hmm.
I probably wouldn't be with her, too, though.
Ooh.
I don't have a problem with that.
Tom Dyson, the most, not the lesser. He ain't going to salt dude with
her. Got standards, son.
I don't have an issue with the salt nigga putting meat the girl mouth, you know what I'm saying?
Because I'm going there for that. Like, if my girl want that, then you know what I'm saying? Oh, well.
So that's part of it? Like, every meal that nigga come in?
Yeah, he that's like his presentation, you know what I'm saying?
I just won't request that. I was like, yeah, let's take that off.
Just don't try to put steak in my mouth.
Yeah. What if your girl requested, though? Like, what if she's like, I want that?
You know, that's she,
that's cool, I guess. Yeah, whatever.
Like, I don't give a fuck.
Let her have her fun,
You can put steak meat, lamb meat.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't give a fuck. Wagyu meat. Stop saying.
But see, it's different when she put her tongue out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's really on her. She was trying to deep throat the calf. I'm like, damn, why you?
I ain't really
seen nobody stick their tongue out like that and tilt their head back to eat steak.
That's just like at a hibachi. Like, them niggas be trying to like throw it in your mouth.
Oh yeah, they pop the shrimp in your mouth. Yeah.
You ever see that shit?
Yeah, I have. I don't throw meat.
Man, just put it on the plate, bro. I'll eat that bitch.
It is meat though. Like,
it is.
You got crazy emphasis whenever you say it.
You need to understand. Ain't no meat being thrown around me.
He placed it on her shit. You know what I'm saying? And Buddy was like, "Damn, I didn't know you was gonna, you know,
stick your tongue out."
I mean,
hey.
It could have been worse, maybe.
I'm saying, it could have been worse. You know
it could always be worse, honestly.
I don't know how it could be
worse. Could have, you know.
It's salty ass steak.
She could have cut herself.
Right. Okay.
Oh, yeah. You thinking that way. No,
that's
way
that
meat,
no.
The meat could have been too hot. She could have.
Hey, that meat probably would have been fresh. All right.
That's how you sound when eating hot meat.
I know they had an argument on the way home. How you get down, huh?
Yeah, I mean,
like you said, you seen that ass in there.
So it was acceptable.
I've heard that the
I'm trying to find it.
Never mind. I'm not even gonna say
it. What you about to say?
Oh man.
But I don't know, son. As long as he, because I saw the video of him trying to put like do the same thing with like Amari Cooper, and Amari Cooper was like, nah, like you're not about to be force feeding me steak.
That's what I'm saying.
Like,
put the meat on somebody
else.
I'm good,
son. I can cut my own steak. You know what I'm saying?
Just drop the little salt. Move on.
He got Dallas turned up.
That's what he ever said.
Right, mm-hmm. That's what salt dude. At. I ain't calling
salt dude.
Yeah, yeah, salt dude. Salt man.
Salt. Yeah. Nigga.
I can't really eat a lot of salt, so I'm kind of turned off of the steak with a bunch of sprinkled salt on it.
Do you cook without salt?
No, I don't.
Oh, okay.
But I don't really cook personally. But
that's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
I should. Well, what do you mean though? Like, I probably should eat like healthy. But yeah, that's what I'm saying. I can't go.
I mean, you can like, you don't have to salt things. Like, there's other spices. That's why I was asking if like you cook without like they got the Tony Sasheries that don't have salt in that bitch.
If I'm eating a steak and you got to put salt on it after it's cooked, I don't really want it.
Well, but you want to salt the steak though. Like, that's really all you need. Honestly, you don't need anything else.
I'm saying, but like,
I don't
yeah, okay. I feel you.
You're on the same page.
Yeah.
Little meat convo.
Yeah, yeah. Salt the meat.
Yeah, let's cut this meat segment short.
For sure.
Little crazy tangent.
How many we have a meat counter? You said it so much.
We probably burned about 50.
50 meats. You want to talk about?
Speaking of meat.
Okay.
All right.
A-Rod cheated on Jennifer Lopez.
What they got to do with meats?
A booty meat?
Speaking of meats, hey, be happy, A-Rod. You know,
allegedly,
you think he was unhappy.
I ain't gonna say the cheat. You gotta be unhappy, but maybe that nigga wasn't, you know, satisfied with J-Lo. So,
but didn't he just retire? Like whenever they got together, wasn't it like around the same time that they got together or whatever?
I don't know, cause I know J-Lo was fucking with Drake a little while ago too, wasn't she?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know the timeline of these niggas' relationships.
Yeah.
But
I just feel like, man, he on top of the world.
They had a 2-year engagement though. They cut their engagement.
They had a 2-year engagement. They also had a commercial together and shit.
Damn.
So it's just like, that's down bad.
Damn, shake back. Son.
Yeah. Shake back both of y'all, bro.
He just got caught up. That's what it was.
I mean,
you in support of that nigga.
Right, I'm just saying, bro, be happy, dog.
How old is Jennifer Lopez?
I think she like 50.
Like 50?
I think 50. Everybody 50.
Mm-hmm. No, 55. She probably got, you know.
Is she like candidate for finest 50-year-old?
No.
51.
Why is she not candidate? Why is she not a candidate for
she
that?
She up there. How old is Halle Berry? I think she like 50.
Is Halle Berry finer than Jennifer
Lopez? Halle Berry like 46, I think.
Let me see how old. I don't want to give.
Because I don't know. I was just asking because Jennifer Lopez looks great. That's all I wanted to say.
But who? Wait.
Yeah, she 54.
You think Halle Berry at this age is like still fine? I'm like
yeah.
She's all right. But she not the. I don't think she's at the same level as she was whenever like she was in. Was that Swordfish or whatever?
Like that's like how many years ago?
Yeah, that like that's what
I'm.
Ago.
But I'm just saying,
she's
like,
still banging. J-Lo
has like kept it there. That's all I'm saying. Halle Berry she's like not the same.
Y'all know I'd be on the J-Lo hate train sometimes though, because I'd be tired of seeing her ass. I didn't need to see J-Lo at the Super Bowl, whatever year that was.
Yeah,
she was up there with Shakira shaking that ass.
I'd never be mad at seeing Shakira, but you see, I just got my bias.
Shaking that Latino butt. You know,
all right.
Would you cheat on J-Lo if you was A-Rod?
If I was A-Rod, yes. I probably.
Dude, damn, I was like,
yeah. I mean, he's in New York, son. That shit is crazy. This nigga Yankee. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
legend.
He just got money, man.
Yeah, so like in New York. Yeah. Come on, son. I'm sorry.
It's J-Lo, though.
Yeah, it's J-Lo.
That's different.
Right. She can buy you like a Lamborghini.
That's just clout.
Like,
maybe he just wants some ratchet pussy, man.
Yeah, I mean,
maybe.
We got to see who he cheated
with. Yeah, it don't mean. Yeah. It might not have been ratchet.
Because if she busted, then
you know, I mean, he could
the
like
niggas, the women niggas get caught cheating with never really find her. Like, I like can guarantee the chick that he was fucking probably not find it in J-Lo.
I mean, he could build a bitch.
He didn't want to say.
I didn't want to say.
But you can't do that. While, I mean, you probably can, but like it'll be a difficult task when you engage to someone
for 2 years.
I mean, but if you got money like he do, you can keep something top secret.
Wait, what are we talking about? Like,
just, I was saying, I'm sure the woman he cheated with probably wouldn't find it in J-Lo.
Yeah. She's probably younger.
Maybe. Mm.
That's what he wanted, probably.
J-Lo gonna be straight, though.
Because, I mean, if you shoot any higher, you're hitting the 60s. I mean, how old is A-Rod? He's pretty old, huh? 40-something?
Yeah, we doing a lot of ages today. Let's
look at we are, ageism. Because we got a topic on here. I see old people in electronics.
What is?
I don't know who put
what
this
did
in
that
there.
You ever like had to deal with an old person?
Like, oh, like helping them fix shit and set up shit. Yeah, I'm turning into that. I ain't gonna lie.
You just don't know how to operate shit.
Yeah. I can see it happening. Mm. Like I can see like why old people get frustrated with technology because it happens with me.
But like, what would you? What were you fucking with that like really got you to that moment?
Literally,
in time?
Like,
was it like a printer or something like that?
Yes, a printer this week, a scanner.
Oh, that's different though. That's different. Like I get frustrated with
like
them
the
bitches
printer
too.
Couldn't find my computer. I'm like, it's plugged into the motherfucking computer. Like a lot of shit. Like I ain't gonna stunt. I ain't get my week recap, but that bitch was poo too.
What happened, yeah, son?
Just nothing worked how it should, bro.
He's so frustrated.
Real nothing. Shit though. That's low key.
It's like damn, the Wi-Fi fucking up. Like, it's 2021. Mm-hmm. We don't have good Wi-Fi in the house.
Thanks.
So I'm in that bitch about to break the router, and I'm like, damn, I dropped my iPhone. This bitch over with already. I dropped that bitch in the sink again.
Damn, bro.
You know
shake
what I'm saying?
You ain't got no case on your shoes.
How you dropped it in the sink? Like
brushing your teeth?
Nah, I was exfoliating.
Okay.
And that bitch was on the counter. I was playing music on that bitch. You right. know what I'm saying? I'm washing my face. You know, I'm like the commercials. I use Buku water. I just throw it in my face. You know what I'm saying?
Like on a Neutrogena commercial or something like that. Yeah.
Cold water. So it spilled on my phone a little bit. So I'm like, oh, damn. Let me dry my phone off.
Right.
So as I'm like... You know what I'm saying? That's I'm trying to drop my phone off over the sink. That bitch like fell. And, you know. So yeah, you know, fuck
shake
my life,
back, brother.
Shake back.
That's get why I'm wearing case. All black today.
And okay. In memory of your phone?
It still works. It's just fucking trash.
Yeah, it got a green light on that bitch.
Yeah. You got a bunch of dead pixels on that bitch. But like, to answer the question, like working at Target, that's pretty much what, and like Office Depot, whenever I was working over there. Dude,
just old people?
Just straight old people, don't know how to do shit.
Just tripping, son. Yeah. Can you set up my phone?
I want to introduce a bill where old, like if you over 65, you cannot drive.
That's some real shit, actually.
No, I actually feel that.
Or like, vote.
Yeah.
But
yeah. Because they have, like it doesn't matter what goes on. Like unless something like dynamically changes, like you got to pay more taxes or some shit like that. They don't have any reason to really
be moving around and shit.
Yeah.
I feel like
you old as hell.
Like,
you retired.
Y'all fucked up with them old people drive, son.
Man, it's like it's a difference though.
Dangerous.
No.
Right?
Dangerous, son.
How many times have you been on the interstate and you've been behind somebody, like you trying to get somewhere and you get to a point where you're frustrated and you just pass them up and you look to the right or the left or whatever and it's some
that happens old
people
every day.
Yeah.
It's like, bitch, move. And then
exactly.
You go around them, it's like, oh, man.
Gilbert,
yeah, I feel bad. Like,
see,
damn,
I don't be feeling
bro.
Bad. I be like, you fucking bitch. Like, I get angrier. Like, yeah, you old fuck. Where are
exactly.
you even going?
That induces road rage 1,000%.
Yeah, I don't want to be mad at
stupid
an old
ass
person.
Stupid ass Oldsmobile.
Yeah. But, like, can you stay home? Or, like, you know what I'm saying?
Just get the fuck out the way. Like, they should have, like, streets for them or, like, an interstate specifically for them.
I
honestly.
Empathize with them on electronics, though. I do.
I fuck with old people. Just, you know what I'm saying? Don't,
I fuck with old people.
I fuck with
just
old
like,
people
don't
in general.
Don't ask me no electronic question.
Well, I mean, I'll say this. Old people be tipping.
Old
you know?
Tipping.
Yeah. Yeah, like, especially whenever I'm working in, like, a retail environment. And it's like, oh, you did such a great job. And you know what? I got so many crazy questions for you. You know, I'm just a crazy old lady. I don't really know nothing.
Old people are cool.
She give you a tip, too?
Yeah, take this $20.
Oh, she kiss him on the cheek and give him
nah,
a 20.
I get,
okay.
Yeah, I get no kiss.
Man, I like but that, yeah. Chris. You know what I'm saying? You got to make it how you live.
Hey, man. Yeah.
My mom would call me one day and said her Wi-Fi wasn't working. I went over the computer wasn't even plugged up. I was like, ain't shit working.
Like,
Momo.
How hard did you try?
Maybe that was the trap. Maybe that was like, just come over here and check on it.
I guess.
Well, clearly,
I
that bitch wasn't plugged in. She needed some help.
Yeah, I think she just wanted
you know, just set that bitch up.
I
get your ass out the house. You wasn't doing nothing anyway.
Right. She gave me a bag of like chicken legs.
Wait, was it cooked?
Nah, it was just raw chicken legs. She'd be having shit at the house.
Yeah.
Okay.
Still worth it. I'll definitely do that for some chicken legs.
I turned that computer on fast as a bitch and left.
You dialed back.
Yeah, it's on now.
How far did you have to drive? Like,
it's like 20 minutes.
It was like a good little drive, yeah.
Okay.
That's right.
I don't know. That could be a little frustrating.
Yeah. Y'all seen YoungBoy just not fucking with Features and just
I mean, would you really expect that nigga to do like, you know what I'm saying, Features with like who it was, Lil Baby? Well, I can see that.
Well, yes, Lil Baby, yes. But
J. Cole
was gonna try to sun him. It's really what it was gonna be like.
I just straight up didn't want to hear it off top.
J. Cole, NBA YoungBoy song?
No. I don't want to hear that
but
shit.
But you know we stand on J. Cole music. I personally just don't like J. Cole's music.
Yeah.
What would it be about?
I don't like J. Cole. J. Cole's music is okay. J. Cole
as a
famous person. I don't like when people try to do that thing. It was just like, oh, I'm just like you.
It's like, no, you're not just like me. You got millions of dollars. We do not have the same problems.
Same struggles, you know.
No.
I sat on top of the house. Y'all felt that?
Exactly. Oh, I got a chick pregnant. Oh.
Like, come on. That's really J. Cole in my mind, son.
I just don't tap in with J. Cole, so yeah. I just didn't want to hear that shit.
Well, I mean, I do fuck with Youngboy declining the 6ix9ine feature. They allegedly 6ix9ine offered him $1 million for a feature.
Yeah, he turned that shit down for sure.
Kudos to that brother.
If you're 6ix9ine, did you really expect him to do the song?
Nah.
Do you expect anybody to do a song with you?
Well, yes, because he has money. That's the thing. I think that's where it comes in.
Because
he got Nicki Minaj on there, and didn't 6ix9ine and Kanye do something, or am I tripping?
Was this before he went to jail? Yeah, all this happened before he went to jail.
It's just weird how he's still relevant too. Like,
the internet keeps him relevant, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Somebody is like behind like him, like his manager or some shit like that. He gotta have like a hidden agenda.
Isn't it what's the guy's name? I forgot. I'm not good with rich, white, powerful people.
I have no clue.
But some guy over at whatever label he's at. I think you mentioned the guy last week. Whatever, some very powerful. He's the son of some super like record label exec. Mm-hmm. So he's in there, you know.
Yeah, I mean, like, they say he's like a Fed baby or some shit like that. He's like working with the Feds, some shit like that. So
both of them, probably.
I mean, to get off on a RICO case that is like fucked up so many people.
Yeah,
like, regardless of if you do snitch or not, that's put so many other people behind bars and they never got out.
Well, that's how that works.
So so it's crazy. He got to have some type of crazy pull.
They said J. Cole waited for 8 hours.
For your boy?
Yeah.
And they said Youngboy just was having a bad day or something.
Yeah, they said
like
he
that.
Was just fucked up. His energy wasn't right that day or some shit.
I fuck with that. Sometimes you gotta take a.
Well, can you tell me like after an hour or something?
Right,
like,
8 hours. Nigga, that's a long ass time.
Nigga, that's a shift.
J. Cole just stupid. He just waiting.
Parked out. DRG. Yeah.
Maybe he made some songs or something.
Oh, I wanna touch in with this young man. You know.
Please don't.
Let this man
make this music, bro. Let him. You know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have been mad at a Youngboy. J. Cole song. I wanted to see what it was gonna be.
It probably would have been cool.
I am curious.
They might have worked it out.
J. Cole and 21 Savage was cool, unexpectedly. Y'all fuck with that?
It was good as fuck. I like
Sterling don't fuck with that.
It's cool, bro. I don't be listening to these motherfuckers, bro.
I'm just checking for J. Cole. Yeah.
I just like whenever it comes to J. Cole, I just don't listen to that shit. I'm sorry. I just don't tap in.
Oh, you just turn it off?
I don't listen to it. I don't click on it.
You ever been in like a spot and like J. Cole playing? Like, what you gonna do?
I ain't completely hate the nigga.
We're not gonna shoot your party up if you play J. Cole.
Like,
you know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
That's intense.
Yeah.
But why are you playing J. Cole at a party anyway?
I've been at a party played J. Cole before. That shit was weird. I forgot what song it was. But Kenny was there. He looked at me and said, J. Cole?
It's time to dip.
Yeah, we did.
It's time to dip. No hoes about to shake no ass right now.
That shit was funny as fuck. But yeah, young boy, I don't think he down bad. But
nah, bro,
don't stand niggas up
for 8 hours,
son. That's so long.
Yeah, that's a little messed up. But it is what it is. If he really had a bad day, I mean, sometimes there's been situations like that.
Yeah, yeah, so. And I get that. You want to tap in, just at least give a nigga a notice, like
yeah.
So y'all see it's Grammy weekend. Wait, is it Grammy weekend? I believe.
Yeah, I believe that it's Sunday.
Yeah, Grammys come on Sunday. Fuck them first and foremost.
Only person I want to see is Freddie Gibbs.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
I hope he get that bitch.
Yeah, that'd be really good. Honestly,
weekend officially announced that he's boycotting the Grammys and won't allow his label to submit his albums for consideration anymore.
Shout out to the Weeknd. Yeah.
So
because of secret committees.
Oh, okay.
He better be careful too, though.
I mean, shit, he at the top of the game, man. It's like, even if he do go out, they gonna put him up there on Michael Jackson.
This nigga
status,
just released the greatest hits album.
The Weeknd.
I don't think it was the greatest hits. I think it was, but it was before the Super Bowl thing. It was to like fuck with the streams and shit like that. Yeah. It was to get his popular songs and put them on a body of work.
Mm-hmm. So, greatest hits.
Yeah.
Essentials.
Yeah, it was essentials pack is really what it is. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And that's what they were submitting to the Grammys. Or?
No, I was just saying,
in terms of where he is in his career, this nigga just dropped the greatest hits and he not even. Done, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's in the middle of his career.
I mean, crazy. But like, Trilogy is like, it set the tone for a lot of music that we hear today.
Yeah, it's just kind of insane that the Grammys didn't nominate him for shit.
Yeah, I think Beyonce said that she didn't want to like perform on stage or some shit like that just recently. I think I saw that before.
Good.
Yeah.
Fuck so, the Grammys, man. At this point, that bitch bunk now. Like, after they fucked over Kendrick with that Macklemore shit, I just like gave up. I don't watch that bitch no more.
Yeah.
It's over with.
So you tapped into the BET Awards?
I watched that before the Grammys.
I'm not really tapped into any awards.
Besides. Yeah. Like,
you know what I'm saying? I try to tap into the Oscars, but I don't watch enough film. Mm. So I never really know was being nominated for shit.
Wow.
So I'm trying to do better with that, like watch good movies.
Did you watch Parasite?
I did not watch Parasite. I don't mean...
Oh, you need to watch Parasite.
Was it was scary?
No. Okay. It's not like a scary movie. It's a drama, and it talks about class warfare and shit like that.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It turns into like a little thriller.
Is that the Korean movie?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay,
I heard that was really scary. An amazing film. I watched that bitch twice in the same night. That bitch like 3 hours long. Yeah,
that bitch grasped you.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, because like once it gets to like the halfway point and it turns into like another movie.
That bitch really turning up. Same. Yeah, it's so good. Yeah.
Okay, I might have to.
I'm gonna tap in. I should have tapped in maybe a year or two ago.
Nigga still ain't get me on the Plex, but it's cool though.
Oh, we gonna talk about it some off, son. Okay. Oh yeah, we gonna bless everybody.
Niggas want me to watch all these movies. I can't watch the bitch.
Give me $5, everybody gonna be straight.
Oh, for sure.
That's all you need.
That's all I need is $5.
Oh, let me tap in. I never heard it was $5.
This is what I was talking about. GB tapping us in, we just don't be caring.
You just don't be caring, son. I had a presentation one day.
He had a whole presentation.
You had a Plex presentation?
I did.
Oh, you weren't here. You went home.
Oh, okay. Yeah. See that?
But I don't remember.
But we told you about it.
We did.
I ain't hear shit.
It's okay, though, son.
We gonna get the Plex going.
Did y'all see Timbaland's nasty ass recently?
What he was doing?
All right, so this nigga Timbaland, you know, super producer.
Yeah.
Virginia. Shout out to Virginia.
Yeah. But I don't wanna like show love after this shit.
Oh,
yeah. So Timbaland, I don't know if this was an old interview. I'm assuming it was an old interview that just came like popped back up. Mm. Timbaland basically said he was in love with Aaliyah when she was 16.
Yeah.
And he was 23 years old.
I think they was talking about this last year, actually, because somebody else was talking about Aaliyah.
She was 16 and he was 23.
Yeah, he was like, he was in love with her.
Mm.
And then he said something about his wife.
He said he married his wife because she favors Aaliyah.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta see how she looks.
Like, he's like, I knew she was the one. She don't look like Aaliyah.
She don't look like
that nigga tripping. Like, she
throw it off.
Like
bro.
At all, she don't look. Like
I don't think. I didn't see it.
Okay.
You just feel
after that. Like you should have just.
That's not cool, my nigga.
Yeah, just tuck that information.
Yeah, what made you feel like that was okay to feel? Just feel.
Fat ass filth producer. That's what you is now. So when everybody see you, you look like a fat ass burger that produce beats and shit. You ruined your legacy because you did this lame shit.
You need to see that nigga like recently.
You think
it
ruined his legacy? I don't
know. I mean, because it's still creepy as a bitch to say.
It is.
I don't think it ruins his legacy, but it takes the spotlight away from like the work and it makes it focus on him because he's like, you don't want to support somebody that's creepy.
You don't.
That's really all it boils down to. If you just shut the fuck up. Ain't nobody gonna say nothing, honestly.
How old was R. Kelly when he was fucking with Aaliyah? Well, how old was Aaliyah?
Around that age.
She was, they was all fucking with her around the same time, dude.
She must have had like a mature.
I don't
want to
say they were all fucking around with her because Timbaland, I don't know if he was fucking around with her. He just said he was in love with her.
Yeah.
R. Kelly was literally having sex with her. So I don't want to put
that in the
same box.
They got married. They got married. They got married.
R. Kelly, that's what I'm saying. I don't want to put Timbaland and R. Kelly in the same box. But they both were creepy.
But he was probably. Man, Timbaland was probably looking at RK. He was like, "Damn you!" Nigga was jealous. Nigga was probably jealous.
You know how crazy that is. Like, how many super famous people that we love was around R. Kelly and Aaliyah around that time in the 90s when that was going on and just
Jay-Z?
Didn't say shit.
Yeah, they didn't give a fuck.
Jay-Z was around the time.
Yeah.
What, did they give a fuck? I don't know.
Yeah, they. I'm pretty sure they all gave a fuck, son.
That's crazy.
Because it's like
but they were probably dick riding like, damn, R. Kelly's so hot right now. I can't tell him shit.
What, yeah. Dame Dash fucking with Aaliyah too?
Yeah. Dame Dash.
The industry was different back then.
Right.
Unfortunately. I don't know. That's just weird to me. It's like, damn.
But nah, son, y'all said it wasn't weird when Drake was texting that 13-year-old. The little chick from Stranger Things.
Millie Brown.
Yeah.
That's
I don't take her
shirt
on.
Yeah, you do got Stranger Things shirt on. He was texting that little girl right there, bro.
But Millie 11. What is that? She was saying it was like, you know, she got a real good relationship with him just to be talking to him like that.
He said that she was giving him relationship advice.
She was giving him relationship advice?
Yeah.
What the fuck is wrong with Drake?
Yeah, niggas don't see it though, son. My theory is in probably like 10 years.
The problem is,
it's gonna come out. some wild shit.
Problem is, women don't care enough. If they gave a fuck, niggas would give a fuck. Niggas only care about what they care about. Facts. Niggas only listen to Drake. Niggas only cape for Drake the way they cape for Drake because they think women love Drake.
So they pretty much dick riding.
Yes.
Very heavy.
Damn.
Yes.
To the point where you wish bitches would fuck with you because you love this nigga so much.
Pretty much.
That's
wild as fuck. That is just you a grown ass man. Like, why are you doing this?
Nigga, what? There are grown ass men that look up to 18-year-old rappers right now.
Yeah.
No, like, that is very factual. And a lot of, there's a lot of lost niggas in the world. That's just all it is, dog. These niggas is lost and broke. So if you combine that together.
Definitely lost.
A junkie.
I can agree.
I mean, it's unsettling, but I mean, it happens.
Drake down bad.
People create one-way relationships with celebrities, and you know what I'm saying? And it creates, like, fans, fanatics.
Yeah.
Stans.
Yeah, niggas trying to say that they just move different, and, like, a 13-year-old is, like, 20. Like,
No, it's different when you rich and famous, bro, because when you rich and famous, lifestyle different. Like,
you can talk to people.
Tiger can fuck Kylie when she's 16, bro, because they both rich, nigga.
That happened too. This is a lot of wild.
But I think the
age of consent is like 16 out in California.
17 or
something. Or 17, 17, yeah.
All right, cool. Legally, so, it's cool, but it's still creepy.
It is. But it's a reflection of the laws, though, at the same time.
I get it.
Yeah.
But, you know,
down bad.
What else do we have besides these?
Let's take a break.
Rich, creepy niggas.
You think you want to take a break?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, baby. Say, oh, baby. I'm straight. Shit, I'm hungry as a bitch. No, I'm not eating that shit. I do want chicken tenders. They got chickens there? I said chickens. Huh?
I just said that they.
What?
You didn't know that? What? I'm confused.
I just, the only reason I know is because I looked at the menu. That's what I was saying.
Oh, I thought you said you need to look at Muse. I was like, what the fuck I did?
Yeah.
Man, I don't know what I'm gonna eat. I want some canes.
What time?
Yeah, they cool. I should do that. Yeah, cause we almost threw all them bitches.
This is his wife?
Nah, let me see.
Maybe
when she was younger.
Maybe years ago.
I can see her favoring Aaliyah when she was younger. Maybe.
She looked like Rosie Perez.
Yeah, she looked more Rosie Perez than Aaliyah. Timbaland, crazy. He a wild nigga, son.
I like the 40.5.
Okay. Yeah, we don't really have to. I don't know how we'll be able to.
Fuck that square.
Yeah, I don't really care about him that much. We can talk about that if y'all want. What else? That.
Oh yeah, the Megan. Okay.
I didn't really tap in.
Oh, getting hit in the car.
Okay. Yeah, some of y'all talk. I think I went through all the topics I put.
Yeah, the STD white woman.
No, I didn't want. I wasn't talking about that. I was talking about another thing. That chick that blah, I, blah. With, I was in a love triangle with.
Blah blah.
I linked up with her this week.
Oh, okay.
She told me that she had like a love. She wrote me a love letter that she never sent me.
Hold it down. Hold it down to
me. So like after we stopped talking, she got with this other dude with Rebound. Apparently, like one night he got mad and went through her phone and like saw the love letter, threw the phone at her face and woke her up by the feet.
Damn.
That ain't funny, man. That's fucked up.
Damn.
That's so crazy.
Damn. Bitch. Chris, you fucked up with it, son.
Wake your ass up.
I ain't gonna do it.
That is fucked up.
Oh, yeah, it is abusive.
I would have hit her with a pillow or something. Like,
I wouldn't have hit her at all.
With a whack. With a pillow, like, it, you know.
I wouldn't have went through a phone.
Ooh, he probably broke that whole nose.
Right.
Nah, that nigga ain't having a conversation after getting cheated on.
Yeah.
You ain't even, she ain't even send it to you.
Look at you, son.
And I was just
look
like,
what you doing. Like, look what you doing to people's lives. Oh, stupid ass.
All I wanted to do was just fuck with her. You know what I'm saying?
And you got that girl in trouble.
I didn't do nothing. It wasn't me.
You got that girl beat up.
I didn't ask for this to happen.
Was the dude white or black?
Huh? Oh, it was a black dude.
Yeah. He did that bad.
Oh.
Did he throw the phone in her face? She exaggerating? Or did he?
I could believe her, but like she be going through a lot. She be getting abused on the regular.
Oh, yeah. She just fucked up. Nah, this is abusive. Yeah.
I'm out my business, me.
Yeah, I ain't. We ain't gotta talk about that.
Yeah.
I'd rather you talk about the STD bitch.
Oh, you wanna talk about the one time I fucked with a white bitch?
It was a black woman?
What are you talking? I just said it was a white chick. Wait. What? No. Y'all talking about the chick that I was talking about. Yeah, she is black and Hispanic. What was I going to do?
Shit. I didn't stop making her fuck with you.
I didn't know that she was getting abused.
Ooh-wee.
Yeah, and then she was doing some shiesty shit. Well, we were talking. Okay.
Stop loving this woman. You getting her beat up.
I'm not talking. We not even like talking like that.
I don't think he loves her.
It was over. The situation was over. She beat the nigga up, and then she moved out. She in Houston now. Like,
oh, so she beat him up?
She handled her own situation. Yeah, that was a toxic relationship. What? How was that my fault? How was it?
Stop being you, son. Like, you should have never made it.
We weren't talking for months.
She fell in love with you.
No. You not listening to me because you just saying that. I need to protect her. You're not listening to me. Oh, raising your voice. Okay.
To ours.
It don't be a nigga business, though. They asked me last week if a nigga was in the store shooting. Leave. If I know her, it's different. It's good.
So you gonna fight somebody? Okay.
Yeah.
Son, like, he's so childish. Why you put the whip?
Name a time a black woman has gone.
I feel like he's speaking on a situation that you don't know about. Okay. Well, then. All right, then.
Name a time a black woman has gone above and beyond to help you.
All right. Well, I feel like it was because it was like
Arsh got
branched off.
I mean, in Chris' situation, he can't really help this woman because
like, I hadn't talked to her.
This already happened.
I hadn't talked to her in months. You just saw her the first time. Yeah, this was the first time that she told me the situation.
The only thing Chris did wrong was making that girl fall in love with him.
True. What else am
you
I
You should have never been a Casanova.
Top love.
I get it. I'm
the last
yeah,
time
so
a
that's,
black woman
that's what I was responding
you
to.
You
got to
be
okay.
careful with people's personal relationships too, though. Because I could know somebody that's getting in an abusive relationship, and I'll try to help, and they'll both, like, turn on me. You know what I'm saying?
Because some people just be down bad.
Oh, I ain't doing that no way. That
I feel like
business.
That's what you – I thought that's what you were saying.
No, I'm saying, like, there's so many resources where you can help and assist that person
to
out, maybe get involved.
Yeah. Like, well, that was my thing. That was my situation with her. And I think that's why she gravitated towards me, because, like, I...
You her
like,
soulless.
She was telling me, like in the...
Soulless.
What?
Place of refuge.
The conversation was, like between me and her, like,
what is that? She said it was easy to talk to me about like feelings and shit like that. Just all sorts of, because she found me whenever she was in a fucked up position. Like, I had lost my best friend. She had just lost her best friend around the same time. So we were able to like, yeah, we were able to like, but it was, I don't
trauma bond.
I guess it is a trauma bond. I guess it's just like, yeah, I hear what you're saying. But yeah.
Has a black woman ever helped you, Arsh?
Yeah.
I wish I could relate.
Black women ever helped you?
What?
Oh, black women. Yeah. You doing Wanda bad.
My mama?
Yeah.
That don't count. This is, of course, my family helped me. I'm talking about
a random black woman.
A random black woman helping me.
What is a random black woman going above and beyond to help you with something?
Okay, I appreciate it. Black women gave me a tip at Target whenever I put this 50-inch television in the back of that car. A lot of Target. Yeah, shout out to black women. So
I love gonna... black women. It's Black Women History Month.
Why do you have to say it like
that? I just want to stop the trope of black men don't do shit for black women.
Let's go. What topic do we want to go back into?
We was about to talk about.
Did you want me to tell the story about
the one time that I fucked with a white chick, dog? All right, so.
Oh, you're about to get into this.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we was talking about this last night. Yo, yeah. I remember you saying that you didn't believe that I didn't only fuck with black women. Like, I only date black women. But like, this was a situation where I went to a party. And, you know, I guess I was on, like, a dry spell. I hadn't really, like, been fucking with anybody or whatever. And, like, you know, she was feeling herself, and she was, like, laughing at my jokes and shit like that. She was like, oh, ho, Chris, you're so funny.
Big funny.
Oh, my God. She German? Yeah.
So, like, man, this is such a crazy story. Yeah. All right. So, like, so boom. The chick that had the party, she already had like a crush on me or whatever, but she was like in a committed relationship with this white dude.
That was hosting
like
the party?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. So it was already a weird situation to be in.
Oh, yeah,
I was
dumb.
In that bitch. I was just like, shit, free pizza, free drugs, free alcohol. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Rager. Let's go.
like the baby. Yeah.
Let's go. So, we talking and shit like that or whatever, and then we get on the couch, and like this one nigga, he brought over like a Nintendo, like a modded Nintendo 64 or some shit like that. He was trying to play a bunch.
He's trying
to play a bunch of like party games, like Mario Party and shit like that. Like, everybody said that they was gonna play Mario Party, and then like an hour passed and nobody wanted to play Mario Party, and he was like really upset. So he was just like, "Fuck this." So like everybody went to sleep.
It's a sleepover.
Well, everybody like left. It was like a small little party. It was like 10, 12 people, 15 people at most at the same time. So the situation, what happened was, me and her was like on the couch, and you know, we was just like we was waiting for a moment in time where this like it could be like pitch black, you know what I'm saying?
Ready to
but like this nigga was just like, I'm gonna play Resident Evil 4, and I'm gonna play that bitch from front to back all the way through the entire night.
Okay.
So it's like 2 a.m. 3 a.m. 5 a.m.
Oh, this nigga's just still playing
the game. Okay. And he making comments. He's like, I see y'all over there.
Yeah,
this one of the, so like, understand, to like give y'all more context, this was like niggas from EA.
Okay, it sounded like it. Yeah. These aren't normal niggas. I never want to be in this type of
environment. It was one of them situations. Like, I was just like, I ain't got shit else to do. I was just like, might as well just like pull up.
Fuck
or whatever.
This white whore in a room full of people.
So you thugged it out to 6 a.m.
I didn't fuck her on the, but like, we was just fucking around on the couch, and like people say that blue balls don't like that's not a real thing. Yes, it is. Yeah, it is very real, most definitely. All right, so boom, that's the party. Like she took him and like the nigga that was playing the game and like another nigga home, and we was gonna like link up later on the next day.
Mm-hmm.
So that happened, and
this where it take a turn.
Yeah, this where it take a turn, because it was just like,
All right, so it's like I try to jump straight into it, you know what I'm saying? Just like get it and go, you know what I'm saying? With the situation.
Yeah, that's just how it be.
It is what it was. Like, we weren't in the moment anymore. Like, it was different. And then it was just like, I powered down, and then she was just like, okay, it's okay. We could just talk, you know what I'm saying? So I was just trying to be like freaky or whatever. And like, I had intentions to eat some cat.
Oh.
And,
you anticipated to eat some web.
And then that's whenever,
premeditated.
That's whenever I smelled something fishy.
Woo!
Yeah, and that's whenever it was just like, yeah, this is not happening no more.
Yeah,
but oyster plate. But we was just.
I'm about to eat an oyster plate.
I was just like, I'm not going to do this no more. Yeah. And so she was just like, so she flipped me over and she was just like, she gave me the Becky. So I was just like, shit, all right. This is the craziest head I've ever had. Mm. I ain't going to lie to you.
For sure.
Yeah. And then, so this is whenever I found out that she had something for real, for real. So it was like, I want to say the next week, it was like that Monday or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Niggas was having a conversation about like the party or whatever, because there was another nigga that was there.
Boy, at work?
Yeah, at work or whatever. So like two people was having a conversation about it. And he was like, yeah, you know, Chris fucked Melinda and shit like that.
That nigga just put you out.
It's like, I don't know, bro. It's like, it's such a crazy environment over there. Yeah. So it was like, one of the dudes was like, did she tell him that she has an STD?
Oh.
She didn't tell me that she had an STD.
Damn.
Yeah, but luckily I wrapped it up, you know what I'm saying? Safe sex is great sex, most definitely.
Oh, so you got top with a condom on?
No, I didn't. Well, not the top part. Yeah. Yeah, I'm just talking about, like, whenever I did try to fuck. Yeah. Yeah.
You know.
But, like, yeah. And she did not tell me. But I was like, that's kind of chemical warfare, you know what I'm saying? That's like
fucking
on some
right.
shit. Yeah. Yeah, it's a very fucked up situation. She hit me up like a few weeks later after the fact, you know, trying to like check in. Mm-hmm. It was like, bitch, you sick. Stop talking to me, bro. And ain't talked to her since, bro. But she apparently, cause like we had been, I've been talking about it with so many people. I'm just like, dog, like she's so down bad. Mm. Apparently she was feeling like depressed and shit like that. And I'm just like, how do you feel bad because you got in a situation and didn't let nobody know that you had an STD, dog?
And you still won't be freaking.
And you still,
I'm sorry that happened to you.
Stupid chick from Plaquemine. And she only fuck with black dudes. She be saying some crazy ass shit. Dog, she was talking some shit to like one dude. She was like, the sins of black people are in my blood.
Oh, man, what?
Fucking
with a succubus. Old
exactly.
Country
that's
bumpkin
ass. Like, that's why I was just like, man.
Stop fucking demons.
Yeah.
You leave that hoe alone.
Yeah.
Leave that hoe alone, Chris.
Like I said, that was the only time I ever fucked with a white chick, dog. Yeah.
I'm sorry that experience was just so fucking.
No more white horrific. Women.
Yeah, no more white women.
2021.
Who said that?
AB. Yeah. Antonio Brown. Didn't won a Super Bowl after that. Yeah. So there's some facts to that shit.
Yeah.
But he's still fucking with the white women.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
But the next chick that I was fucking with, she was black. She was
for sure. So, yeah. Eating black women in your life, dog. Elevate.
Yeah, that was crazy. Wild.
Speaking of interracial relationships. Huh. Hey, my segue's retarded today. Speaking of, it's the only transfer like segue I know. So.
Yeah,
but
go
yeah.
Ahead.
No, what's the interracial? Oh, Meghan and Harry. The fucking whatever the royal family, I forgot the name, Meghan Markle and Harry.
Yeah.
Whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Rich white man's seen a bad bitch. He's like, I'm cuffing that.
Fucking with
his family. From the States. Mm-hmm. Rich white folks from England, you know, the royal family. They was like, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, we killed your mama.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we're going to let you live with this interracial shit. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going to step on you, too.
Hmm.
And apparently, you know, the media clearly did not fuck with her.
Nah.
Yeah, that's
they would bash her every chance they got because she's black.
Black woman.
And she had an interview with Oprah recently, about a week ago, where she basically came out and said, yeah, the family didn't support me. I was depressed, thought about killing myself. They didn't give a fuck.
Right.
Damn.
And they would ask her questions about how dark her child would be.
That's so crazy.
Like light skinned woman.
Right.
Yeah. With a white man.
Right.
Right.
And you think this baby about to come out dark.
Looking like Wesley Snipes.
You think this baby going to be, you know what I'm saying?
That baby going to look like Charlie Murphy.
No.
Exactly. So like Charlie Murphy.
Like, yeah. Why would y'all? But you already know they racist.
Yeah, they were just racist and bitch. They was nervous.
How crazy. What do y'all think? Like, I'm not going to say I'm surprised because I'm not surprised that they feel this way, that family. But I'm glad she was able to come out and say that shit in an interview.
Well, yeah. I mean, but they had to. She got Harry to, like, you know, they no longer part of the family no more. Yeah, so it's like, at this point, you got to go on the media.
Divorced
run.
His family. He shit, was like, man, that's fuck crazy, y'all. Yeah. I'm gone.
Hey, man.
Good. Hey, protect black women.
That's hard,
you know,
as fuck
what I'm saying?
That he chose that woman over his
fuck
family.
Fuck Queen Elizabeth.
Bro.
Like, how the fuck you still around?
She offering the cookie up, son. That's all I'm saying.
I guess
it's different, son. You can't really combat that, bro.
Hey, bro. I don't know. I didn't see what all the hoopla was about.
Like, what you mean?
Like, I mean, they just racist rich white people.
Yeah, they've been like had a history of like.
But do you want the outrage to stop though? I feel like it needs to continue until something actually come from it.
But what's going to happen? Like, nothing. The Queen of England, like, you know what I'm saying? Ain't family, shit, like, you know, gonna happen.
You can't stop people from being racist.
Yeah, it's still exposing it, you know?
That's what I'm getting at. As long as, like keep on putting that information out there that these people are racist, and something will change of that.
It just sucks, like...
100%.
I don't know. I just feel like some shit should be obvious.
Yeah, but...
But I guess it's not. And it's the royal family. It's a big deal. I get that. I'm not saying don't do it. It's just... At some point, we got to stop acting surprised about this type of shit. Not us, but people in general. They were really...
Yeah,
they was fucked
like,
up, man.
Yeah, they was really fucked up. And I was like, damn, like, I thought this was expected.
I don't know, man. People be living in their own bubble, son.
One of the funny clips... It's not funny. Well, I guess it's funny to me. She said, were you silent or were you silenced? You seen that shit before?
That was Oprah asking that question? Yeah, that's funny.
Man, that should have me joked. Because, like, she moved her eyebrows up when she said it. Like, damn, I killed that shit. Like,
you know, this the one.
That's the clip that's been around. It is buku funny memes of, like, Oprah just... Like making funny ass faces throughout the interview.
I have to watch it.
This is crazy.
Shout out to Harry, man. Fuck, he is like, fuck my family, bro.
Harry a real nigga though.
Dipped
the
on
day.
The family.
Man, what else do we have? What are the topics?
Oh, I got a topic.
Yeah, you got to talk about your topic. Yeah,
that might be the last one.
Yeah,
because I mean, there's some people that feel me, and there's some that don't.
Just don't make no sense to me, dog.
I said getting head in the car, not cool. Let me rephrase that. Getting head in the car has cons.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Has some big cons.
So you're saying that it outweighs the pros?
Is it worth it? Yes. Yeah. But I don't like riding home in buku spit, you know what I'm saying? And my gym shorts feel like I'm sitting in a swamp.
Nigga don't like moist sack.
But at the same time, you got my seat wet, you know what I'm saying? My thing is... All right, let's say I gotta wipe my dick off. I gotta use a random shirt, random hoodie to make sure I'm straight till I get home.
You don't just have like throwaway clothes in your car?
That's what I'm saying. Like, I'm gonna have to use one of those, and I don't want to. I think I had to get rid of it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like,
it's
just, I don't, it's cool, but at the same time,
you just not fucking
when
with
when you meet a tongue demon, let's say that, and she give you just the craziest neck in the car,
right?
And you got buku spit everywhere. You like, damn, I can't shake back. I ain't got shit in the car. I'm gonna have to, you know what I'm saying? You gonna have to improvise with whatever you got.
Keep some wet wipes on you at all times. Like,
I don't know if you wanna be wetter. Like,
keep a little, like, you know, towel or something.
Wet wipes,
like, if I knew prior to getting the top like this, then came with a little towel or something.
Yeah, she was just a wild woman. Yeah, you wasn't prepared.
Yeah, I wasn't prepared for how that mouth was about to be.
Yeah, she went nuts. She went
and you know, I'm like, damn. And, you know, I get out the car, my legs shaking. I'm like, damn, you know, man. I'm about to fall over. You know, Bitch, you done took me to drip season. So I have to clean my dick off.
drip a drum.
You know what I'm saying? And her face was, you know what I'm saying, kind of wet too. And I was like, damn, I ain't got a towel for you. And I just wiped this bitch off with my dick. So, I mean, if you want to use that, you can.
She got to charge it to the game.
Yeah, but.
Exactly. Ooh. You gotta wipe her mouth off like a Neanderthal.
I didn't know you was about to do it. Like, I didn't know you was going to take it there. Mm. If I did, I, you know, would have came properly.
You still talk to this woman?
No. This was years ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you might have to. Check up on her, see how she doing.
Nah, we gonna leave her in the past.
I don't know what to say, son. That just come with the territory.
It does, though. It's just like, I just wonder how niggas felt, you know. Like,
I think you on the island on that one, son. Like, yeah. Really.
Even yeah.
I fuck with it.
It's a con, but I fuck with it. But what at what cost? I'm driving home.
I mean, you know, this ain't got nowhere important.
Did you ever ruin some clothes, like, from... Like, I feel like that's what you're saying.
Nah, it's just, you know, just sitting and spit for like 20 minutes and then, you know.
That's a long time.
That's what I'm saying.
That's a long time, yes.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I smell like this whole mouth.
Yeah. You ever smell someone spitting and stink?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lord have mercy. Yeah.
God damn, what is in your mouth?
Like, damn, I appreciate this, but what the fuck do you be doing?
But some people don't, like, use mouthwash and shit like that. And you know you're supposed to gargle. Like, a lot of, like bad breath comes, it's like in your throat. So you gotta, like, gargle. You actually gotta, like, gargle with the shit. People don't do that, all that. They rinse, but they don't gargle.
Mouth signs.
Tap them in, Chris. Clean your mouth.
Most definitely. Make sure
the back of your teeth clean.
All of that. You gotta brush twice a day. Sometimes three times a day. Chew you some Orbit gum.
I'm not mad at Carhead. I think that was just a crazy situation that you was in.
Yeah.
She did the most.
Because it doesn't happen every time, but that.
Yeah, she put you in the pool.
To be the Blue Bayou. Ooh, baby.
He said his leg was shaking.
Yeah, I was shaking. I was like, God damn. I was like, damn, I feel every nerve in my body. Hey, but you know. Shout out to her. I hope she's doing good.
Me too, son.
Yeah, I hope she's doing fine.
Absolutely.
Too.
That's a better situation than my situation. So, I honestly, I would choose that situation.
Yeah. Your situation was
that was completely different, nigga.
Yeah, I'm just.
Yeah, that's super different.
Do we have any more topics? I think that was the last one.
I think that's everything.
I think we could end on that note. That was fucking.
That was funny as fuck.
Well, I got to pick a song this week, huh?
Damn,
I don't even know what to play. Let's listen to something happy. I want to play...
Let's get them vibes right.
Stevie Wonder.
Who?
Ooh.
What?
Play ass.
What?
Ass. Not what? Ass, like booty.
Okay. Oh, okay. Stevie Wonder ass?
All right.
Thank you for listening to New Advice Radio, and we hope to see y'all next week.